Hey everyone, my name's Slyk, welcome to another video. In today's guide, we're going to go over Mana Awakening in its entirety. After watching this video, you're going to feel comfortable enough to build your own mana pages going forward. Now before we continue, if you'd be so kind as to subscribe and hit the bell, I'd really appreciate it. Thank you. So, what is Mana Awakening? It's a monthly system that can be leveled up by acquiring Mana XP. You earn 20 mana per level up to level 40, totaling 800 mana. After level 40, you can continue to gain Mana XP, which will help you in reaching higher rewards for when the season or month is over. These rewards can include special titles, transcendent runes, equipment upgrade materials, and a special weapon upon reaching level 70. Though this is a monthly system, you will receive a Mana XP potion at the end of the season. The amount of XP that you will receive will depend on the level that you got previously. Keep in mind that you cannot reset mana once it's been applied. It will require you to buy a mana scroll, which can be purchased from a general store for 50,000 gold. Now, where can you get Mana XP? Typically, you'll get it by doing quests, purchasing Mana XP items from the various token shops, but mainly you're going to be earning that in your daily and weekly dimensional portals. Alright, first we're going to go over the Transcendent Imprints. Each provides its own set of benefits for each class. Keep in mind you can only select one of these. Destruction allows for large AoE damage and shield breaking or CC of mobs. Preparation is utility based and is focused on raising defense while protecting the user and others from CC and damage. Combination fires charged orbs at all enemies around you doing damage based on your stats, however it does not provide any utility, defense, or CC. Key imprints provide various stats and assistive features once applied. Keep in mind you can only equip 3, so choose wisely. After choosing, you can level them up to provide even more bonuses until they're at their respective level caps. If I were to recommend any of these, I'd personally recommend Amplify, Precise, and Scholar. Frugality is also one I'd recommend if you don't have enough energy sustain. I'd replace Amplify for this. I understand that seeing the mana tree at first can be very daunting, so I'm going to break this down as best as I can. Each little circle is an augmentation. These augmentations will increase or decrease your respective stats. The green area is your crit accuracy and versatility. Crit accuracy increases your crit rate, and versatility increases your damage dealt, your healing gained, and it decreases damage taken. The orange or destruction tree is your min and max attack increase or decrease. Each time you attack, your damage is rolled from your min to your max. And this tree is the one that's raising or decreasing those limits. This tree is typically picked by the damage dealing classes. The blue or preparation tree is critical hit dodge chance and critical hit damage reduction. This tree is typically ran by Warlord and Mystic. Yellow or combination is for your max stamina or stamina recovery. This tree is going to give you a higher stamina pool and slower recovery, or faster recovery and a lower stamina pool. Now, each of these trees has a set of Transcendency Augments, as well as a starting augment that provides very good bonuses. I'll go ahead and put those on screen for you to read right now. To obtain the Transcendent Awakening Stones, you're going to need to do your Dimensional Portal daily and weekly and go to Dragon Garden. In Dragon Garden, you can farm Dragon Scales in the Realm versus Realm area past the Poison Dragons. You can also kill the other realm's players to receive these. You can then trade in 20 dragon scales in order to buy your chosen awakening stones. While farming these dragon scales, I do recommend you go in with a party as you may have to fight the other realm to hold your spots. Now when you're assigning your mana points, please keep in mind that those little dots between each augmentation do actually cost points. Each of them do increase your base stats, however. I just want to say be careful if you think you're calculating the amount of mana you need to get to the Transcendent Stone. You may be a few off if you're not calculating these little dots. I won't go into any detail on Transcendency Augments to choose, as I don't have enough information from all of the other classes, but if I were to recommend one, I would recommend the green lifesteal, as that has helped me a ton as a gunner in PvE. I compressed a lot of information in this short video, so please feel free to go back, pause where you need to, and ask any other questions you may have about Mana Awakening or any other feature in the game in the comments section below. I once again want to thank you very much for watching. If you enjoy the content that I'm putting out, please consider subscribing. I'd appreciate it very much. If you liked the video, please like it. I'll continue to do my best to provide you the most clean and concise guides that I can and all of the news upcoming with Elyon. I've had an amazing time with this game so far, and I hope you do as well. Happy grinding on Elyon, guys. Peace.